Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial, and today we're going to look at a few alternatives to using the pen tool. The reason for this is that a lot of people just don't like the pen tool, and there are plenty of tools in Illustrator that you can use as alternatives. Now the first one we're going to look at is the pencil tool. It shares a toolbar position here with the new shaper tool. I'm going to target the pencil tool, but before I start drawing, I'm going to double click on it. Like most of the tools in this toolbar, the pencil tool has options, and it will help you to know what pencil tool options you have selected and also perhaps make some choices yourself to make the tool work a little bit better for you. The first slider here is a slider between accurate and smooth. So if you want the pencil tool to sort of smooth out your wiggly lines, then go towards the smoother end of the scale. If you want to be a bit more accurate, then go to the accurate end. I have selected keep selected, so that means that when I draw a pencil line, when I finish drawing it, it's going to stay selected. And I also want to be able to edit selected paths, so I'm not only going to keep my line selected, but I can also change it. Now I'm also going to select this option, which is close paths when ends are within 15 pixels. I could change that amount, but 15 is pretty good. And this will mean that my paths will close automatically. So I'm just going to go with these settings and click OK. And I'm going to draw the letter A, a chunky letter A. So I'm using a mouse here, so my lines are really, really wiggly. But because I've got the smooth option enabled, things are going to be smoothed out quite a bit. Now here I'm going to click back over my starting point, and you can see that Illustrator has joined this up, so it's one continual line, but it's a really nasty bump in it here. Well, the line is still selected, and I did say I wanted to be able to edit selected paths, so what I'm going to do is just draw back in where I want this line to go. And Illustrator is just smoothing out the line. It's using my new pen line as the fix. So we can do things like this, and that's what Illustrator will give us. Well, I'm just going to undo that. Hand in hand with the pencil tool is the smooth tool. So with this line still selected, you could use the smooth tool to just smooth things out. It will have a tendency to removing excess anchor points if there are too many. Now let me go back to the pencil tool for a minute because I want to cut out the middle of the A here. So I'm just going to draw this in. It's not going to edit the other line because I'm well outside of that other line, but it didn't do a really good job of joining it. Well, let's just go back and see if I can join it, and I did. Let's go back to the smooth tool and just smooth out the bumps. Now, if you're working with an earlier version of Illustrator than Illustrator CC, you may find that the pencil tool doesn't behave quite as well as it is for me. It got a bit of a makeover in Illustrator CC, and it does tend to work a little bit better and a little bit more intuitively these days. Now, right now I have two shapes. If we go to the layers palette, you'll see that I have two paths here. So if I were to fill this, both of these shapes would fill, for example, because I don't have this as a cutout. If I want a cutout, then I'm going to use another one of the tools that I recommend using as an alternative to the pen tool, and it's the Shape Builder tool. With these two shapes selected, if I select over the Shape Builder tool, I can now either join them together or I can remove this piece, and I want to remove this piece. Right now my mouse pointer has an arrow with a plus symbol beside it, telling me that if I click and drag, I'm going to join things together and make a single shape. Well, I want to take this piece out, so I'm going to hold the Alt or the Option key and then just drag over this piece to say, this is the piece I want to remove. Now I have a compound path. And now because I have a compound path, if I select this and switch the fill and stroke, then I'm getting a filled shape with a hole in the middle. The blob brush tool is another tool that you can use as an alternative to using the pen tool. It works a little bit differently. I'm going to select the blob brush tool and then double click on it so that we can see its options. Again, we can keep the area selected that we're working on, and we can also select to merge only with the selection. We also have our fidelity options from accurate across to smooth, and we can adjust the size. Now you can also adjust the size of the blob brush using the open and close square bracket keys, but it works a little bit differently to what you might expect because it tends to forget that setting when you go to use the blob brush again. Whereas if you change the size here, then this tends to be sticky. So I suggest that you get as close as you can to the size using this size slider, because using the open and close square bracket keys to adjust the size is a little less effective. So I'm going to click OK, and let's just draw a heart shape with the blob brush, and remembering that I have smooth set on, so it's going to smooth itself out quite well. I've only drawn half the heart, it's still selected. Note that we're seeing this as a filled shape, so when you use the blob brush, you're not drawing lines with anchor points on them, you're creating filled shapes. So let's go back here and let's just add this to the blob brush shape. So our heart here is a hollow one. It has a hollow middle and the sort of outline is filled. If we wanted to fill in the middle here, then we're going to need to come in here and make quite a big size brush for the blob brush. And now I can just come in here and just fill in the middle portion. It just works a little differently to the pencil tool, but it is a way of painting shapes. So pretty much if you can paint the shape, you can create it using the blob brush. Now, hand in hand with the blob brush is the eraser tool, because you can use the eraser tool to erase portions of your shape. Again, it's got a set of settings, and if you want it to be a bit bigger, you can adjust its size. So let's go and take out some circles from the middle of our heart shape. And all we need to do is, with the heart selected, just click on it with the eraser tool to remove it. So we'll have a compound path for this object. We'll go to Window Layers and open up the Layers palette, and here is our compound path. The Shape Builder tool that we saw earlier can also be used with shapes. So I'm just going to draw out a rectangle here, and let's just fill it with black and give it no stroke at all. Now let's go and create a circle. So I'll go to the Ellipse tool. I'm just going to drag out a circle and place it just over the edge of this rectangle. Let's fill it with a different color. Now if I select over these shapes with the selection tool, I can go to the Shape Builder tool, which is here, and just target it. Now I can add shapes together or subtract them. So let's see what happens when I just drag over these shapes. Well, I end up with a composite shape that is the combination of the square and the circle, and it's just a single shape. Let's undo that, and this time let's hold the Alt or Option key as we drag over the circle. In this case, the circle, because we held down the Alt or Option key, has been removed from the square, and we have just a single shape here. Sometimes it's just easier to create complex objects like this by subtracting shapes from each other rather than trying to draw it with the pen tool. I hope that you enjoyed learning these Illustrator tools as alternatives to using the pen tool. Let us know what you think in the comments below, and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed the tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.